here tonight and honored to be part of the Monadnock Music Festival. I want to thank Laura Gilbert and Jonathan Bagg so much for doing this festival and for inviting me to be part of it, and Eleanor Briggs for making it possible for me to come. And I want to thank the creative genius that Laura and Jonathan exhibited when they came up with the idea of the Music for the Mountains series, bringing together poetry and music, because these two arts have always belonged together. They're twins, and poetry never really fully comes alive until we hear it. And how much more exciting is it to hear it set to music? And I'm very grateful to have my piece set by the young and wonderful composer, Gabriella. And thank you, Gabriella, for choosing my poem and making it part of this grand musical tradition. I'm going to read you a few poems tonight, closing with the poem that will be performed by the musicians. All of these were written in this region. Most of them were written right here at the McDowell Colony. Last night, I opened with a poem I said was necessary to cool us off in this heat, and it seems to have worked, because today was probably about, 5 degrees cooler than yesterday. So I'm going to read it again tonight, and hopefully it brings the temperature down to another 5 degrees. This is called Poetry of Magic, right? New Year's Day. The rains have washed the ice away, and all over the woods, the birches have dropped their scrolls, whose secret maps lead inside to the tweet, tick, screech, and gulp, to the rumble of distant sky, and the muffled roar of sea, sounds washed in rain like music you have heard before, you have not heard before. The raw material of your life abounded. So all of these poems, I chose them in particular for this event, because they all have the sounds in them. Sometimes the sounds are the sounds of trees, sometimes grasses, sometimes little wildflowers, as you'll hear in this next one, sometimes birds. Now and then, I give myself a talking to. Don't dwell on the fickleness of the past, I say to my face in the mirror. Bring your thoughts to the one certain thing. Think of it when you start to feel sorry for yourself, and think of it when you are happy. Its dark flavor will intensify your joy. Yes, remember it as much as you can. Let yourself be filled with it. When you overhear the mustard bean whisper to the vetch, yellow and purple, purple and yellow, aren't we the beauties of the hill? Think how the snow will cover their traces, and how dumb lucky you are right now. What do you hear? There is a bird that calls 5 calls and waits for its mate. There is a roar of distant traffic or ocean that turns out to be only wind. There is a call like a door swinging open. The foghorns warn without cease. Here is rock, here is the edge. When the mate answers, the bird calls again, 5 calls. The trees look too large to creak, but they do because of the wind. When there is no answer, the bird calls again 5 times. When the wind is up, even the small grasses find their long voice. Nothing to be made of any of it. No lessons in the afternoon sounds. Only the music as the sounds drift apart and float back together into silence. This next poem is called Morning Minyan. A minyan in Jewish tradition is the quorum of 10 10 people that you need to have in order to say certain communal prayers. So this is the morning minion. A quorum of small black birds settles on the birch outside my window. 10 of them, enough to pray the most sacred prayers. Whom do they beseech? For what do they pray with their tutus and dee-dee-dees? Do they ask for grace? Cannot be. They already have it. Do they seek forgiveness? For what? They can't help but do what birds do. Do they need healing? Perhaps one of them has broken a wing? Or are they singing the praises of the creator, of the creation, of the many ilks and varieties of birds? I would like to stay and find out, but I have no time this morning. No time, no time, no time, no time, chance my species. Tick, 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 cry the birds as they fly away. We all have our songs, right? No time. The feast. The laden arms of the oak, the elm, and the agitated hunger of the small jays. The fat globes of white sugar mum, where bees suck love. And you, in the morning shade, tasting the new day sharp and alive on your tongue, are a chorus that says, indulge. The world is abundant. This loving, dying world to which we are given, out of which we have come. Oh, body of the world, eat with joy the body of the world. And the poem you are about to hear, more musically, if I can do it, it's called Earth. I like how it falls, unhurried, between my fingers, leaving traces of itself in the creases, wood and acid, flower and metal, in the crescents of the nails. I like how when I dig in its darkness, it settles its weight in my hand, at home with its child. And how, when I lay it back around the newly planted roots, patting it down with the flat of my palm, it leaves me again without resisting. The way hair, skin, sight, mind go quietly, cell by cell, so gently, I can only imagine to what soft bed, what body, continues throughout the piece until almost the very end.
Monadnock.